Today, we are talking all things lead management and prospecting with HubSpot. I'm Alex, and this is How to HubSpot. I'll walk you through lead handoffs, managing those leads, and actually reaching out to those prospects. I'll also show you how to automate those leads. By the way, it's free to get started in HubSpot. If you want to follow along, just click the link in the description below. Now, let's get started. To prospect with HubSpot, you want to be set up first in the Smart CRM. The Smart CRM is a collection of contacts, companies, deals, and all the data and people that you need to operate your business. Let's take a quick look to see how you can set yourself up for success with prospecting. So if I'm in the CRM here, I want to click on this little CRM icon, and I want to click on contacts. Now, contacts are obviously associated with a single person, and that person can be associated with a company. Now, not all contacts are leads, not all leads are contacts. I'll explain that more in a second. But for now, let's click into a contact, and I'll show you around so you can see what it looks like to have a contact inside of HubSpot. So first, I'll pick one of our contacts here, and you can see HubSpot's already started to pull in some information about this contact. Maybe they've engaged with something on our website, or maybe they've reached out about what we're selling. Either way, as a sales rep, it's my chance to now determine, is this contact a good fit to be a lead? And let's just say for this example, they are. So let me show you how to actually create a lead inside of Sales Hub. So we'll head over here to the contact. On the right-hand side, we've got a variety of different filters and objects that you can associate the contact with. But for now, we will scroll down and find lead. And from here, let's click add and open up that lead form. I'm able to create a new lead, automatically pulling in all the information so I don't have to spend time going through and entering this contact's information again as I create the lead. It's that easy. So I'll just hit create lead. And just like that, we've successfully created a lead for this contact. So we've created the lead. Now you're probably wondering, how do we actually work this lead? How do we engage this person and get them to ultimately convert and become a deal? Let me show you. So if you wanna head back over to the contact view, you can see the lead that we've created right here for this contact. I'll go ahead and I will click on the lead, and I will click view lead in the workspace. The sales workspace is essentially going to be your one-stop shop for all things prospecting and lead management. It's going to collect all of your different calls, tasks, emails, and all of the leads that you're working in a place that's going to make it really easy for you to do your day-to-day and prioritize your time. So you're probably thinking, is the only way to create a lead really to do it manually each time? Well, no. We'll get more into the workspace in a second, but I wanted to take a moment to kind of explain the different ways that you can create leads inside of Sales Hub. So many people will have the marketing team kind of define what it means to become a lead. Maybe this person's engaged in white paper content. Maybe they've watched some of our webinars, or maybe they filled out a form and expressed interest on a website. Either way, lots of times people will be getting leads from marketing, and those will come through a system called workflows. So if I head over here to automations, I can click on workflows. And this is going to show me all of my different automated business processes, not just for prospecting, but for a lot of my sales and marketing motions. For this example, I'll show you quickly how you would create a lead with a workflow. So if I head over to one right here, this workflow is very simple. All we have here is a workflow that shows us every time a contact submits a form on our website, let's say it's to download our latest white paper, we will go in and a lead will automatically be created. So at scale, when you're doing your prospecting and when marketing is working on their different marketing campaigns, they can have leads automatically flow to sales in order to help you streamline your prospecting and not have to manually update leads. All right, I just showed you how to automatically pull in leads. Now there's one more way I want to show you. That's if you need to get a list of leads in front of you to work pretty quickly. Now you may want to do this if maybe marketing went to a trade show and has a specific list of contacts and leads they want you to focus on. You'll want to follow up pretty quickly. So let me show you how. We'll head out of workflows here, and we will head over to the sales workspace, and we will jump into the leads tab. Now here's the create lead button I showed you earlier, where we created that individual lead. If I click on actions, I have the option to pull in leads. Here, I can pull in leads based on their lifecycle stage or based on a variety of different contact properties that I've set up within HubSpot. So no matter how marketing has put these leads into your system, you're able to quickly follow up and action on the leads to hopefully convert them to deals. I'm back in the sales workspace, and I want to show you all of the different ways you can use it to maximize your productivity. Let me show you around. So first, The Sales Workspace is this great collection of all of your calls, your activities, emails, LinkedIn requests, anything you need to do to move the prospecting needle forward and connect with your customers, you can do right here in the Workspace. Up here, we have all of your different calls, your emails, your to-dos, as well as your LinkedIn tasks that you have for the day. You can see I have overdue tasks, so I think I have some catching up to do. Now, down here, we have some of these guided actions. I want to show you a cool trick though. If you are prospecting, go ahead and hit prospecting related right here. And what this is going to do is show you all of the different activities that you need to do in order to engage with your leads for the day. You can see right here, I have a meeting starting in 11 minutes I need to prepare for. I have some new leads I need to start working. It's a really great place to kind of progress through your day as you're prospecting. Now, let's look at that lead though that we talked about earlier. I'll come up to the top and I will click on leads. This is gonna show me all of the open leads that are assigned to me as a sales rep inside of HubSpot. We can find the ones that marketing created, that I created, all in this single view. Now let's open one up and see what it's like to actually prospect and work one inside of Sales Hub. So I will click on this first one here that we just created. And you can see, I have the option to engage with this lead right away. I can make a call, I can set up a meeting, I can create a task, and anything I do is going to be tracked right here on this lead record. So let's go ahead and do a little bit of outreach, shall we? Let's send this person an email. Now, I am gonna give them a nice demo email where I'm gonna ask them to jump on a call about our service. So as soon as I sent that email, you'll see that the stage that this lead is in moved over to attempting. And that's because HubSpot knows I reached out to this person and we're gonna track where they are in that lead journey. What's important to note is that lead management has different stages. Not all of your leads are brand new. You're talking to some of them have already engaged with you. So all of that can be tracked right here in these different stages. All right, so I've sent the email. Now, let's say this person reads the email and they write me a response. Maybe they're interested in what I'm selling or they have a few questions. Either way, as soon as they do that, the lead stage right here is gonna move from attempting to connected and letting me know, hey, you should probably prioritize this lead. Now that I'm in this stage, it's time to really seal the deal and actually qualify this lead. Maybe that means booking a demo call, talking about pricing, or setting up a buying committee. Either way, when I'm ready to qualify the lead, I can do it right here on the lead stage. So I'll come over, I will hit stage, and I will hit qualified. Now what this is gonna do is create a deal for me because this person's no longer a lead. They're serious and they're ready to talk about our product and potentially make a purchase. So when I hit create a deal, I'll be presented with this deal creation menu. I'll go ahead and create and all of the information that we have about that lead, all the activities, all the emails and all the calls are automatically going to be bought over to the deal. That way, you know exactly where you stand and anyone else working on that deal will know everything that's happened as you've been prospecting this lead. Now that I've shown you all of the different ways to qualify a lead, I wanna show you one quick time-saving hack that I discovered that's helped me save countless hours as I'm preparing for these sales calls that we're just now setting up. So I'll show you how to do this in the sales workspace. If you head over here, you can click on schedule, and this is where I'll be able to see all of my appointments that I've been booking as a result of all my prospecting activities. We can see here, I have a call coming up in just a couple minutes that I honestly have not really had the time to prepare for. If I click on prepare, I'll be able to see all the information I have about this contact and this lead that I'm about to have a conversation with. Using AI, I can quickly prep for the meeting and get up to speed. So let's see what we can find out about the meeting. So first, I can have the company be summarized. Copilot's gonna go in, take a look at my CRM, and take a look at the company as well, and put together a brief summary, so I have a better idea of how I can talk to this person's pain points. You can see here, we've also pulled in some of the software that they use already, so I kind of have a better idea about what their tech stack looks like. It's gonna help me sound much more informed when I go to have that conversation. Other couple cool things you can do is summarize different contact records. We can study the customer, we can study the company, and really use this meeting prep tool to get up to speed on how to have the best conversations with those leads that we've just qualified. All right, so I've showed you how to do all of your prospecting inside of Sales Hub. I've showed you how to create leads and manage them and actually work with those leads, but it's time to talk about customization. Now, it's important to note that your lead management, your prospecting process, it might be a bit different. There might be some custom stages and different nuances that you'll need to customize Sales Hub for in order to make it actually fit. Let me show you just how easy it is to quickly tweak these prospecting tools to fit your business. So let's go over here to settings and we will scroll down to data management. I'll click on leads. And from here, we can see the setup. I know what you're thinking. Are we really about to go and reconfigure this whole lead management process inside of Sales Hub? No, it's much easier than that. Let me show you how a couple simple tweaks to the lead management process can help make this more impactful and ultimately really fit your prospecting motions. The first thing I want to show you is how to customize that create lead form that I talked about earlier. If you want to do that, just click on customize the create lead form. And here you have a chance to change any of the information that you want reps to put in as they're creating leads. If I click on add properties, I can search through different lead information. I can add something like business units and anything I want to ultimately customize the form and make sure that as leads are being created in my system, they have all the information that they need to actually progress through. So let's say I'm happy with those changes. I will hit save and close. Now, let me show you a couple ways to customize some of the automations and put some guardrails on how your lead management process will work inside of Sales Hub. So I'll head over here and I will click on pipelines. First thing I can see are all of the stages that associate with leads right here. Let's say I have a bit more of a complex product and I have to determine if a customer is even qualified to buy. Maybe I need to add a new lead stage. I can do that right here. Just hit add stage and I can put any title I want. Maybe I say qualification call and hit save. Now that form that I showed earlier, that's gonna update. And there's another stage for BDRs for reps to work through to make sure we're progressing our leads in the right way. Couple other things you can do here when it comes to customizing your prospecting. If you click on pipeline rules, so on pipeline rules, you can go in and you can do some further customizations. Let's say you wanna prevent leads from skipping a stage, or maybe you have a rep who's always moving things backwards as the due date gets pushed out. You can do some controls here and really make those edits to make sure that your process is adhered to and ultimately you're gonna have cleaner data as a result. Final couple things I wanna show you here in terms of customization. On the automate tab, I can come in and I can add new automations to all of these lead stages. That means if I have specific things that I wanna progress the lead, I can have those set up here and my reps don't have to manually progress leads. Final cool feature, and this is actually a bit of a productivity hack, is something called lead tags. So if I click lead tags and I click manage lead tags, I will be taken to a section where I can essentially create these tags that are color coded and they'll show up on all of my different leads. Let's say I've got hundreds of leads and I don't even know where to look some mornings, right? I can come in and I can create these custom tags based on things like value, how long has the lead been sitting in a stage, customer name, and more. So at a very, very high level visually, I can see where I need to focus my time and I know which leads are the most important. If I wanna create a tag, I can just hit add tag. Let's say I wanna create a tag for those leads that are associated with high value accounts. I'll come over here, I will hit name. Maybe I'll call it something like high value. I'll pick a color that stands out and I'll add filters. You can add any sort of filter that's associated with the lead. So you can really have endless customization options here. Mine's pretty simple. I'll go add a filter. I'll search for what I'm looking for, which in this case is amount. And I'll put, maybe I wanna see any lead that is greater than 1,000. Once I hit review tag, you'll see that it'll apply to all of my lead pipelines. I can hit save and that lead tag has been created. Now, when I go back to my lead board, I'll be able to see a visual representation of all of my leads that are over $1,000, making sure I know exactly where I need to spend my time and where I need to focus. So far, we've talked about creating leads, managing leads, working those leads, and even customizing the entire prospecting process. But now I want to talk about how to actually automate your prospecting, not just to help you prospect smarter and help you reach a wider audience, but to help you really personalize that experience for your customers and ultimately get better engagement and qualify more leads. So let's take a look at sequences, the feature that's gonna help you automate lots of your prospecting. Let's head over to HubSpot and we will scroll down here to the automation section. We will click on sequences. So sequences are a series of automated sales emails along with a variety of manual tasks and activities that you can use to automate a lot of your sales processes. Let's set one up. So I'll come in here and I will click create sequence and I'll go ahead and hit create dynamic sequence. So as you can see, I've got that first automated email ready for me. What we're gonna wanna do is build a series of emails that engage our leads and our customers and ultimately help drive them towards either booking a meeting, requesting more information, or engaging with us so we can get them closer to that qualification point. Let's see what that looks like. So I have my first step automated email right here. I can create an email from scratch, or if I already have some ready, I can select from some templates. So I've got a couple templates. I'm gonna quickly plug one in. First thing I'm gonna do is add the automated email. Now, as you can see, when I added that automated email, on the right-hand side, a series of manual tasks opened up. We'll talk about those in a second, but for now, let's finish building this sales automation campaign. We'll go back and we can see that this email has been pulled in with all the information about a demo for our product. Let's add a couple more emails in the series to really round things out. I'll click on add, I'll click on automated email, and you can do a couple things here. You can start a new thread, or what I recommend and what I like to do is reply to that original email to keep all of your messaging fresh in your prospect's inbox. So let's add email content and let's find another email to add here. We'll add a second one. And while I'm at it, I will go in and add a third one here as well, still replying to that original email. It's time to focus on the manual outreach, or how am I gonna intervene in this sequence when I know someone's engaged? Not always easy to do. But with sequences, you can quickly see when someone either opens or engages with the content that you're sending. So let's take a look. If we head over here, you can see we have two signals. This means that when someone opens one of these emails or when they click into one of these emails, it's gonna kick off the series of manual tasks that I define. So let's say as soon as someone's engaged in the content, I wanna set up a few tasks for myself. The first being a general task. Maybe I should say I need to do a little bit of research. I can come in here and add that as a task. I can even set priorities, low, medium, and high, so I know where to focus my time as I'm going about my day to day. Once I've done that, what I typically recommend doing is sending a manual email. Send something so the person knows that, hey, you've seen that they've engaged in the content, you're here to offer any questions, and just connect on that personal level. So I'll hit manual email task. I can set that as a priority as high and hit add. Couple other tasks you wanna pay attention to in here because not everything needs to be done through email. One of the things I like to do is always send a connection request on LinkedIn. I like to make it a high priority and I like to do this right after I've got that response. I've had a little bit of engagement and back and forth with the person so I can expand my network and connect with them on LinkedIn. Now, what does this look like? If I scroll to the top, we can see that this sequence will send a series of three automated emails to my prospects that I enroll. The sequence is then gonna listen for and wait to see if someone's either opened the email twice or clicked on any of the content within the email. As soon as they've done that, it will pull them out and it will kick off a task for me to do some research, start that manual outreach, and then connect with them on LinkedIn. Finally, to wrap this up, let's add a call. So we can give this person a call, wrap up the sequence, and hopefully qualify the lead. This is a great way to automate your prospecting while maintaining that critical level of personalization that your prospects expect. When it's time to enroll people in the sequence, all you have to do is hit save on the sequence, hit save, and then from there, you can head over back to the sales workspace, click on any of the leads that you have been working, and click on the enroll them in a sequence button right here. And that's how you automate your prospecting while maintaining that level of critical personalization. All within Sales Hub, you're able to work, manage, and automate your prospecting efforts. If you want to manage your own leads and personalize your prospecting, get started with HubSpot. Check out the link in the description below. This is How to HubSpot. I'm Alex, and I'll see you next time.